Graffiti is not only an eyesore, it's a crime. Police and community members hold cleanups, but that does not solve the problem. Marissa Yamani has details on a bill aimed at fighting graffiti. Marissa?
Joe, it's modeled after a law that's helped reduce graffiti in New York, California, Oregon, and Florida. And if you've ever had your property vandalized with graffiti, you know firsthand how much it sucks. Mary Kit DeLong doesn't remember the last time her wall was all one color.
Even our neighbor one, they do too.
And all along the main streets of Village Park and Royal Cunia, same thing.
And then the association do paint, yeah, the whole thing, but then after a week, after even 2 days or a day, and they start writing again.
Frustrating, to say the least.
Looks ugly too, yeah.
And not only on walls, but also on lampposts and even on vehicles like Mary Kit's neighbors.
They have a truck, and then they just spray paint it.
Village Park and Royal Cunia residents went to their state representative asking for help.
And I looked at measures in other states and other counties on seeing what they'd done, and this was something that we came up with.
House Bill 2391 is a measure that would require all stores to put aerosol spray paint cans behind a locked counter or cabinet. So if you want to buy one, you'll have to ask an employee to get it for you.
So the measure is there to stop people from shoplifting the spray paint cans.
And graffiti is a big problem across the state in many neighborhoods.
I don't think this will be put an end to graffiti, but it's a discussion we need to start. It's a thinking out of the box kind of way of doing it.
That's good. Yeah, I like that.
She says anything to help. The bill was heard last week by the Consumer Protection and Commerce Committee, and this Wednesday they'll decide whether or not to pass it out of committee. Marissa Yamane, KHON 2 News.